Last summer, my husband and I we went on vacation, and for the very first time, I had a completely migraine-free trip. This was in the middle of July, and we went to Arizona, so you know it's going to be hot that time of year. I had several of these migraine shirts, this one and the other one that I showed you in a previous video, and I wanted to update you to let you know how well those worked. And they work really good because it helped my husband and I both to remember that I needed to drink plenty of water and avoid those foods that would trigger a headache. We did drive, so that helped because I didn't have to worry about the altitude change, so that was good. And I also took one of these. I don't know if you've seen these. This is called a frog tog. And you can find these in the sporting goods section of many stores. I've seen them at Walmart and several other good stores. They have different colors. I like the blue. They have pink and yellow. The one I took with me was yellow, and since that trip, I bought this one. I really don't like blue. And it worked really good. I wore it nearly constantly. And the weather was, sometimes it got pretty warm. It was in the probably 90s and close to 100. But because I had this, oh, let me show you how to wear it. When it's dry, it's really hard. But when it's wet like this, it's just right. And you want it to be a little wetter than I have it here. You can see it's kind of drying out there. But when you get it just right, it's not soggy so that it soaks into your clothes, but it's very cooling. And by putting it across your shoulders like this, it helps to chill the blood that goes up to your head and helps keep your head from getting too much blood in it, which can cause trigger prime it's one of the primary problems of the migraine. So by keeping this on nearly constantly, I was able to that and keeping well hydrated. I drank plenty of water. I had 2 8-ounce glasses before breakfast. I had 2 8-ounce glasses between meals, both in the morning and in the afternoon. And by doing those things, I was able to have the entire vacation free from any migraines, and I was very comfortable. Since that time, I have found a couple of alternatives that, in some many cases, are a little bit cheaper. This is called a perfect for you cooling towel. It's the same principle as the frog tog. These do stay flexible when they are dry. This one is dry, and they're really nice, and they do keep you nice and cool, just like the frog tog does. And all these are washable, both the frog tog and this towel. But I also wanted to show you another idea. Since I've been using these, I was reading on the label of this one, the perfect one, the other day, and it occurred to me that the list of the type of material used for this is very similar to what is used in swimming suit fabric. And I was thinking about swimming suit fabric and how, you know, it's very cooling. You know, if it's at all damp, it really keeps you very cool. And as it is drying out, you know, the evaporation from on the fabric is very cooling. And so I was thinking about that, and I thought to myself, well, what if I were to get some swimsuit fabric and make that into a something similar to one of these? And I really like those little circular scarves that are real popular right now. And I thought, what if I were to take that fabric and turn it into a circular scarf? So that's what I did. Last week I went out and I got spandex and I think polyester. And it has a lot of stretch to it. And it's very durable. And it's 18 inches wide. Let's see, here's the width of it. That's 18 inches. And then the entire length of it is 62 inches. And what I did is I cut that shape, and then I sewed a seam right across those ends to make the circular part so that it is 18 inches wide. And you get it just a little damp. You don't want it real wet because you're going to end up looking like a wet t-shirt contestant. So you just put a little bit of water on it, enough so that it's damp but not drippy. And you can just wrap it around your neck, and you can do different styles. You can do it just traditional, you know, looping it twice like this. Or one thing I did this morning that felt really nice was I took half of it, kind of spread it out over my shoulders so that it kind of makes a little cape. And that feels really good. And on a hot day like today, it really does help keep the blood going to your head from getting too warm and creating a headache. If you guys want to try it and you like it, if it helps with, you know, if you're a migraine sufferer or you know someone that is a migraine sufferer, try it out and let me know how it works out. Put a comment on the video or email us or something and let us know if it works for you. I had some lemon in what I was eating yesterday, so I am prone to migraine today. So I've been using this and also making sure I'm drinking plenty of water, and I haven't had any problem today. One other thing I've been trying, and so far it seems to be working, that is, I don't know if you've heard of this fruit called durian. It is, it really stinks. It smells like rotten onions. But it has tryptophan in it. Now, tryptophan, you know, a few years ago there was a big problem with some synthetically produced tryptophan. But this is naturally occurring in the plant. And last week I was really expecting to get a headache. I had, again, consumed some lemon in some of the mock mayonnaise that I made. And so I was kind of prepared for the idea that I would probably get a headache. But I ate some durian the night before. You know, normally when I consume lemon, it's about 24 hours later that the headache comes on. So that evening after I consumed the lemon, I had some durian, just a little piece of it. I buy these frozen packages, boxes of durian, and I ate just a little, maybe 3-inch square piece of durian the night before, and then again in the morning I had some with my breakfast. And the whole day when I was expecting to get a migraine, I didn't, and I felt great. So these are some extra things that you might want to try, and if they help you, let us know. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.